Okay, so David Spade has a new audiobook out that he is doing exclusively, I think exclusively as an audiobook. And I like the cover, so we'll just recreate it quick. So we'll do the blue. Put that in. Actually, what I'll do is we'll make it a lot simpler. And then just, now you can, so I usually don't even bother with the layer naming, but we will in this case, I guess, since it's a tutorial. Then all we're going to do is do saturation, click here, and then it's a decent green. Now obviously this one goes right next to it. Do another one, put it up here. Saturation. Click here so it only selects the layer below it. And then we need yellow. Some of these I'll have to actually change up a little bit. Make them lighter, darker, whatever. But for our purposes here, this is no sense in taking a lot of time until, until you decide that you really want to use something. Otherwise, you can just be wasting a lot of your time. Yeah, that looks good. I actually met David Spade one night. I was out in Hollywood and I had these glasses on that kind of Clark Kent glasses. And I was trying to reach over, or actually, I was at the bar. He was trying to reach over me and I was like, "Hey, dude." And then I looked back and it was him and he said, "Settle down, Clark Kent." And then shot the shit a little bit. You know, when you're sitting at a bar and then somebody's reaching over your shoulder and you're kind of like, come on, man. But it was no big deal. Okay, so something like that. It's not perfect, but it's good enough for our purposes right now. And then let's just put these all in one rainbow. And then, typical to what I start out with, I just generally have one common image I use for these tutorials so that I don't have to shoot another one. And then if I ever decide to use a similar idea. So my philosophy is I create things that I like. That resonate with me, and then I generally don't need them for any purpose. But in down the future, since I'll already have it created, it sparks more ideas, more unique ideas that work for me, right? I mean, this idea, there's no reason I would use this for any purpose, so I won't use it. But I guarantee it'll spark an idea down the road. They always do. Once you create anything that your mind enjoys, it'll start thinking of other things that you enjoy as well. Okay, let's say, obviously Marshall Wayne. You gotta make this bigger. Black and then so we whoops okay this isn't at all what I would do at the moment, but I don't want to take up too much time on doing a font at the moment because I have other work to get done. Actually, I can't stand how that looks, so maybe I'm gonna have to change it, but nah, we'll leave it for now. Obviously, we'd think a better copy than that. So, to make this more professional, we'd do a few other things. Add some gritty layers, make the font better, because the font really does suck how I did it. Go to my old standby. Let's try this. Let's just do a free transform instead of. Let's do that. And then do the same here. Okay. That's feeling better. Looking more professional already. Still not there yet. So, like with anything, you'll get it looking decent, and then you'll start thinking, well, that doesn't look professional yet. And then you just keep sort of just doing little tweaks until it starts to look how it should look. Like a professional shot. Now, also, I would probably myself do this, do a black background. So once you get the idea out, then just start making it how it would work for you. And then when you end up using it in the future, it'll already be ready for you. It'll already be looking a certain way. Then I wouldn't use the rainbow colors either. My business doesn't have anything to do with Polaroid, and it just doesn't fit at all. But that doesn't mean it's not going to spark an idea in the future. I might put, let's say, an American flag there. Honestly, actually, let's do that. All right, here's how the ideas come. American flag. Now, normally I would go purchase the image from here. But I'm not going to use this at the moment. So if I ever did need it for an ad, I would do that. I would probably purchase this one. But you get the idea. We don't need to do that at the moment because we're not using it as an ad. We're just using it as a test. Let's use the distressed one and turn it. And then we will go transform. So now we're talking, right? And then let's just cut this off. Now we're cooking, aren't we? Yes, we are. And then obviously, then our font doesn't work. Let's just put it in a folder and then let's just click invert and then this. And we'll have to then do a drop shadow to make it stand out a bit. All the way black. A little bit like that. So Again, we would keep working on this. But that's how you take one idea and let it lead you to another. And there's obviously many possibilities we could do with this David Spade cover. Jesus. Idea. And then I'll put it in the vault templates. And there we go. So you guys take it however you will. If you'd like to just purchase what I did here, you can. I'll leave a link and hope you like it.